Hello, hello, welcome. Hey, Victor, how are you?
Hello, teacher.
Good evening. It's a pleasure. Juan Alfonso, too. Welcome. Good evening.
Thanks. Good evening.
Okay, Mai. Welcome, Mai. Welcome to the class. So let's start with the class right now. I will share the platform in this moment, right? Let me share it with you. This is the one, right? Okay, we are going to review the demonstratives, this, that, those, and these, right? And the pronouns one for singular countable nouns and ones for plural countable noun, right? Okay, let me see. I am having problems with the platform, right? La plataforma está dando algunos problemas. Pero, bueno, ya me dejó accesar, okay. Very good. Now, let's review the video. Please pay attention to the video.
In question.
This lesson, participants will be able to use demonstrative pronouns. This, these, that, those, to express possible choices.
Hello, this is what we're going to do. We will listen to the audio program first. Try to follow the topic, and as soon as it is done, we will talk about it.
Demonstratives. One, ones.
How much is this necklace? How much is this one?
How much is that necklace? How much is that one?
Which one?
The blue one.
It's $42.
How much are these earrings? How much are these?
How much are those earrings? How much are those?
Which ones?
The yellow ones.
They're $18.
Prices.
$42.
$59.95 or $59.95.
As you realized, we're talking about demonstrative pronouns. As you know, there are four. This, these, that, those. I know you have studied this before, so we will make a quick review. This, singular, near. These, plural, near. That, singular, far. Those, plural, far. Therefore, we use is for this and that, and are for these and those. In English, we use one or ones very often when talking about choosing or having more than one option. For example, I ask, is that your car? Which one? The red one or the blue one? The red one. Yes, it is. The words one or ones always go at the end of the question and answers, and they replace the noun in question.
Okay. So this is the review, right?
As you realized, we're talking about demonstrative.
We were learning about the demonstratives, right? This, when it's singular, right? That, when it's singular too, but it's far. These, when it's plural, and those, when it's also plural. But these is when it's close, and those when it's far, right? Also, we were practicing prices, right? Here we have the $42, $33, et cetera, et cetera. But when we have cents, we made like this, 59.95 or $59.95, right? Let me see, here we can practice some prices, right? Let me see. Okay. For example, if it is for $25, right? $25, simple like that, right? But if we have cents, we have, for example, 65. So we have $25 and 65, or $25 and 65 cents, right? Let's practice with a price that is higher, right? For example, $178 and 90, well, this is very common, right? 99 cents, right? So we have 178.99 or $178.99, right? So you have two options when you talk about cent, right? Okay, now let's continue with the platform. Good. Now,
pronouns.
We have,
as
the
you know, there are four: this, the, plural, near, these, plural, near, plural, far.
The pronouns, one and one.
Therefore, we use is for this and that when talking about.
Good. So when we're talking about one option, to choose this or to choose that, this is my favorite, but this is not my favorite, we use the pronouns one and ones, right? One for singular countable and ones for plural countable, right? And yesterday we were learning that they are substitution for noun. Let's say, for example, if you like, let me tell you what, houses, for example, right? A house that is color blue, for example, and the other house that is color, I don't know, white. So and then you say, I like the white one, right? That when you use one, you're saying the substitution for house. So you say, I like the white one. But we use this when we already know the information, when we know what we're talking about, right? And we use, for example, ones in plural. Let's say, for example, the restaurants. Mm-hmm. I like the Pizza Hut restaurant, right? But someone can say, I like these ones, right? So in that case, you're talking about restaurants. Ones is a substitution for restaurants, right? So as I said, when we have an option, when you choose something, you can use one and ones, right? As pronouns. Other reason for using this is in order to not be repetitive, right? Do not repeat the same information. For example, in the conversation, we were learning we were talking about earrings, right? Instead of saying the earrings, says the blue ones, mm-hmm. the yellow ones. So ones were was a substitution of the earring, right? Okay, so this is the review. We're going to read the commentaries. Here we have the commentaries of Rosa. Said, how much is cost your car? Okay. Which one? The red one or the gray one? Okay, that's good, right? But Rosa, here we have to use the auxiliary does. How much does your car cost? How much does your car cost? Oh, how much is your car? Mm-hmm. So we can eliminate cost and only say, how much is your car, right? Let me answer to Rosa, right? And I say, how much is your car, right? Okay. Submit, right? Teacher Javier Gomez, answer Rosa. Okay. Oops. Okay, good. Now, Alonso Tejado, let me see. Well, Alonso, how much does the red shirt cost? Ah, that's okay. That's the red. Mm-hmm. How much does the red shirt cost? Which? Mm-hmm. Better here, Alonso, you can say which one, right? That one? Uh-huh. Okay, I will answer Alonso too, right? Which one? Huh? So the use of the pronoun, right? That one In this case, we're talking about, you know, a singular countable noun. The red shirt is only one, right? This is my answer to Alonso, right? But then the rest is good, Alonso. Very good. Thank you. That is my car. That's the house. Okay. Now, Roxana, Carolina, Caro, right? How much is this dress? This one? Yes, comma, that one is $35. Okay, nice. Good. And I don't know who's this. Let me check. Hilda, no, it's not from our group, right? Vicky, no. Rolando Campos, right? Let me see Rolando Campos. How much does this wedding ring? Oh my goodness, wedding ring. I guess Rolando is having plans to get married soon. Okay. But Rolando, you have to begin with capital letter. Don't forget, right? How? It's with capital letter. But the question is good. How much does this wedding ring cost? It's perfect, right? This ring costs him only $100. Only, excuse me. Only $150. Okay. That's okay. Thank you, Rolando. Thank you, Carolina. Thank you, Alonso. Thank you, Rosa, for your commentaries. Thank you very much. Por ahí me estaban diciendo que había más comentarios. Oh, yes. Let me see. I have more. No. Oh, sorry. No, ya no hay más. Only this, right? Okay. Again, thank you for your commentaries. Now, let's continue with the next one, right? We didn't see this yesterday, right? Pronunciation stress. Remember that stress is the pronunciation. Es la mayor fuerza de voz, right? Okay? Donde va la mayor fuerza de voz. Let's watch this video, okay? Pay attention.
Hello to all of you. I want you to pay attention to the stress given to the important words when speaking.
In this lesson, participants will listen to sentence stress in order to improve pronunciation.
Sentence stress. Notice that the important words in a sentence have more stress.
Excuse me.
They're perfect.
I like the blue one.
They're not very attractive.
The idea is for you to listen to the audio and then repeat. Practice as many times as needed.
Okay, now let's practice, right? Let's practice together the pronunciation. Let me see. We're going to start with Alonso. Ah, sorry. Josué. No, I have Victor, José Alonso, Juan Alfonso. Yes, let me see. I have a problem here. Let me check. Excuse me, class. Okay. I'm going to start with, yes, José Alonso, please. Hello. José Alonso.
Hello, teacher.
Okay. Tengo un pequeño problemita. Su nombre me aparece en el cuadro de Josué. Josué, ¿verdad? Sorry, José.
Dice que aquí a todos me parece que tienen mi nombre, todos los compañeros.
Se ha hecho popular, José.
Sí, ese es plagio.
Ese es plagio. Todos los derechos reservados. Me le van a pagar por a José favor. Alonso o el nombre. Ok.
Sí, no sé qué pasa.
Bueno, entonces, vamos a comenzar entonces con Josué. Josué, can you hear me, Josué?
Yes, teacher.
Okay,
yes.
Now, I need you to practice these sentences, right? And pay attention in the intonation, please.
Okay.
Okay, please, let's begin. Repeat, please. Come on, excuse me.
Oh, okay, excuse me.
Continue.
They're perfect.
Okay, no, wait.
They're perfect.
Sorry, Jose. Excuse me. They're perfect. Listen, they're perfect.
They're perfect.
Okay.
They're perfect.
Continue.
I like the blue one.
Excellent. Continue.
They're not very attractive.
Okay. That's it, right? Now the real, ahora el verdadero, José Alonso, right?
Okay.
I'm sorry, it's funny. Excuse me, José Alonso, perdón, que no me esté burlando usted, ¿no? La situación es bien chistosa. Okay, come on, José Alonso.
Okay, please. Excuse me. They're perfect.
No, they're, sorry.
They're Alonso. Perfect.
They're, they're perfect. Listen,
they're perfect.
They're perfect.
They're perfect.
Okay, good.
I like the blue one.
Excellent.
They're not no, very attractive.
Sorry.
They're not very attractive.
Okay, good. Let me explain this. Listen, because this is very important. Just give me a second. I will explain this. Okay, there are four words, right? They are, there, that means allí, I'm sorry, and there, su de ellos, right? Now, the three words have different meaning, right? Las tres palabras tienen diferente significado, but the pronunciation is exactly the same, right? So you say, there, and there. The same pronunciation, right? The same pronunciation. But listen again. There, right? Everybody repeat. There.
There.
Okay. Do you understand? So next time you see there. the three words, you pronounce them the same way, right? Alonso, yo creo que este es un virus, fíjese, porque no sé si vieron aparecer aquí varias veces el nombre José Alonso. Dije yo, me están asustando también. No sé, no me explico. A veces el internet, el Zoom, a veces es un misterio. Pero bueno, estamos haciendo famoso a José Alonso. Now, let's continue.
Compartí el enlace, creo, ahí me acaban de mencionar eso, que puede ser.
Puede ser ahí que sea apropiado de la identidad de todos ustedes, ¿verdad? O sea, ok. Now let's continue.
Se están escudando en mi nombre.
Aprovechen ahorita. Víctor. Hello, Víctor.
Hello, teacher.
Repeat, please. Repeat. Excuse me.
Excuse me.
Continue, continue.
They're perfect. I like the blue one.
The blue one.
They're not very attractive.
Okay, nice. Mai, please. Ready,
hello.
Mai?
Hola.
One, two, three.
Excuse me.
No, 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 Mai. For you, it's a special. Listen, excuse me. Okay. No, I'm kidding. No, continue, continue.
They're perfect.
Uh-huh.
I like.
I like the blue one.
Again. I like the blue one.
Uh-huh.
They're not very attractive.
Okay, thank you, thank you. Now, Rosa, please. Hello, Rosa. Repeat, please.
Excuse me. They're perfect. I like the blue one. They're not very attractive.
My goodness, Rosa, congratulations. Okay, Alicia José Alonso. I'm sorry. Ahí le aparece también, Alicia. Okay.
Es que entré con el enlace que envió Alonso en el grupo.
Ah, okay, ahora entiendo. Okay, vaya. Ya ve, José Alonso, es que usted nos dio ya el pase, por eso todos están con... Okay, continúa, Alicia, continúa. Yo creo que lo hizo con intención, va, que era hacerse famoso, José Alonso. Ok, sí, Alicia.
Excuse me. They're perfect. I like the blue one.
Mm-hmm.
They're not
no,
very... They're not very attractive.
Okay, they're not very attractive. Again?
Yeah. Attractive. Okay.
No, no, the full sentence. They're not very attractive.
They're not very attractive.
Okay, thank you. Now, who's next? Rolando, please. Rolando. Repeat, please.
Excuse me. They're perfect. Perfect. I like the blue. I like the blue one.
Okay, but listen, Rolando, like a little bit more natural, right? Like, you know, I like the blue one. I like the blue one. Huh? Come on, again, Rolando.
Oh, I like the blue one.
Okay, that's it.
No, they're not very, very attractive.
Okay, very good. Claudia, please.
Hey.
Repeat, Claudia.
Excuse me. They're perfect. I like the blue one.
Okay.
They're not very attractive.
Okay, thank you. Now, Miguel. Hello, Miguel.
Somos dos Claudias. Okay. No se le olvide.
I'm sorry. Okay. Ahorita se iría entonces de Claudia Ordóñez, ¿verdad? ¿Claudia?
Sí, así es.
Okay, I'm sorry. Sí, tengo los dos nombres. De ustedes no se ha apropiado de su identidad todavía José Alonso. Así que sí tengo sus dos nombres. Así que me va a disculpar. Okay, Claudia Ordóñez, please repeat.
Excuse me.
Okay. Excuse me. They're perfect. I like the blue one. They're not very attractive.
Okay, thank you, Claudia. Thank you very much. Now, Miguel, please. Miguel.
Hey, okay, teacher.
Repeat, please.
Excuse me. They're perfect.
No, wait. There.
They are perfect.
Okay.
I like the blue one.
Okay, aquí, cuidadito con este, va. There, okay, come on, again, read.
They're not very attractive.
Attractive, huh? You know, attractive. Thank you, Miguel.
Attractive.
Yes, thank you. Now we have, who's missing? Juan Alfonso? Juan Alfonso?
Yes, teacher.
Yes, right, no me ha practicado, ¿verdad, Juan Alfonso? Okay, now,
no.
Please, excuse me, come on, go ahead.
Excuse me, they're perfect. I like the blue one.
Like this, listen, I like the blue one.
I like the blue one.
Okay.
They're not very attractive.
Attractive, okay, thank you. Now, who's missing? Ana Maria, hello, Ana Maria, welcome.
Hello, teacher.
Repeat, please.
Okay. Excuse me?
Franco, venía a ver que este ya que estaba jalando la cortina. Ya, ¿qué estás haciendo?
It's the dog, right? Haciendo travesuras. Continúa, okay. Ana María, continúa.
Okay. They're perfect. Uh-huh. I like the blue one. They're not very attractive.
Okay, very good. Cuidadito ahí con la cortina, ¿verdad, Ana María? Okay, now.
Hola.
Alejandro. Hola, hello. Okay, Alejandro, please repeat. Okay, Alejandro, repeat.
Excuse me.
Okay, nice, very natural. Continue.
They are perfect.
No, they're
perfect.
Uh-huh.
I like the blue one.
Mm-hmm.
They're not very attractive.
Uh-huh. Listen, they're not very attractive. Attractive.
Very attractive.
Okay, thank you. Who's next? Cindy, please. Hello, Cindy. Welcome. Good evening.
Hi.
Repeat, please.
Excuse me.
They are
perfect.
Good.
I like the blue one. They are not very attractive.
No, Cindy. They're
not very attractive.
This is attractive. This is attractive.
Attractive.
Very good. Thank you. Now, who's next? Carolina, right? Hello, Carolina.
Hello, teacher.
Come on, repeat.
Excuse me, they're perfect. I like the blue one. They're not very attractive.
Okay, but the last one, they're not very attractive.
They're not very attractive.
Okay, good. Remember that when we read, even in Spanish or in English, it's like a song, right? Es como que estuviéramos cantando, right? because there is a rhythm. Es como un ritmo, right? En el español nosotros no lo sentimos, pero porque ya lo hablamos, ¿verdad? Entonces lo mismo sucede con el inglés. Hay cierta como ritmo ahí, ¿verdad? Con música. Okay, who's next? Noemí, hello, Noemí. Please repeat.
Hello, teacher.
Hello, come on, repeat, Noemí.
Excuse me. They're perfect. I like the blue one. They're not very attractive.
Good, thank you, very good. Thank you. Now, who's next? Lorena, hello, Lorena.
Hello, teacher. Good evening.
Good evening. Come on. Come on. Excuse me.
Excuse me. They are perfect. I like the blue one. They are not very attractive.
Okay, nice. Luis. Hello, Luis. Welcome.
Hello, teacher. Good evening.
Good evening. Come on. Repeat, Luis.
Okay. Excuse me. Uh-huh. They're perfect. I like the blue one.
Excellent.
They're not very attractive.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Who's missing? Vamos a ver quién me falta. Alejandro ya estuvo, ¿verdad, Alejandro?
Yo falto.
I'm sorry. ¿Qué? Alejandro ya, ¿verdad? ¿Quién me dijo? I'm sorry. Ando perdido.
Claudia. Claudia Castro.
Perdón, entonces yo me equivoqué. Me van a disculpar las dos Claudias, que siempre me equivoco, ¿verdad? I'm sorry, Claudia, please. Claudia Castro, please, repeat.
Excuse me. They're perfect. Mm-hmm. I like the blue one.
I like the
uh-huh. blue one.
Okay.
They're not very attractive.
Excellent. Very good. Thank you. Nobody's missing, right? Nadie me faltó, entonces.
Thank you.
Okay, you're welcome. Nobody, right? Claudia Castro, Claudia Ordóñez. Now, Claudia Castro, Claudia Ordóñez. Okay. Now, see. Let's go to the next part. We have now the PowerPoint presentation, right? I will show you the PowerPoint presentation for the class today, right? For the 3.8, 3.9, 3.11, 3.12, right? Now, we're going to make this fast. Which one do you prefer? Preferences, comparison with adjective, right? Okay. Now, let me see. I'm sorry. Ana Maria, please, can you read the objective for today, Ana Maria?
Yes, teacher.
Read.
Lesson objective. In this lesson, participants will listen to a conversation and will be introduced to comparison with adjectives by expressing preference.
Excellent. Thank you very much. Today, adjectives, comparative adjectives, right? Okay, now, the vocabulary for today, wool, warm, leather, stylish, price tag, tried it on anyway, right? So repeat after me, please. Wool.
Wool.
Warm.
Warm.
Leather.
Leather.
Stylish.
Stylish.
Price tag. Tried it on. Tried it on.
Try it on.
Try it on.
Try it on.
Okay. Anyway.
Anyway.
Anyway. Okay. Please. Now, do you have questions about vocabulary? Do you understand?
Yes, teacher.
Tell me. Tell me. Tell me.
What's the meaning of wool?
Wool is lana. But no money, right? Money, no. It's de lana,
de material, right? De tela, ajá.
Ah, yes. Okay. Any other question?
Trying it on es try como intentarlo.
No, es probarse algo. Probarse, try it on, probar algo. Like, imagine okay. You're try it on, try the shirt on, right? Pruebes esta camisa, right? Try it on. Or in plural, try them on. You're trying some shoes. The shoes are two, right? So you say, try them on. Probarse los dos zapatos, right? Try them on. Okay? Probarse algo.
Thanks.
Welcome. Any other question? No. Okay. So let's continue. Let's continue, right? Okay. Ah, so that was the vocabulary. But now we have the second objective, right? For the second part. Noemi, can you read the second objective, please?
Yes, teacher. By the end of this lesson, you will be able to comprehend and use comparative adjectives.
Thank you very much. Now, let's go to the carnita of the class, right? Comparison with adjective, right? Use comparative adjectives to compare. Listen, pay attention. Two. No one, no three. Two. To people, to places, to things, to ideas, to animals, to houses, etc., etc., right? For example, right? Do you have these pants in a larger size? It comes from the adjective large, but the comparative form is larger, right? I need shoes that are more comfortable, right? So we use the word more to indicate that it has a higher degree, right? Que la palabra cómodo, right, tiene un grado más elevado, es más cómodo, right? Do you have a pair
teacher,
of, sorry?
The perfect pronunciation, comfortable.
You can say, there are two pronunciations, comfortable, or comfortable. I prefer comfortable, for me it sounds more like more elegant, right, for me, right? Comfortable, but some people say comfortable, right? It's acceptable,
okay.
Too.
Okay.
Acceptable. Comfortable, comfortable.
Oh. Okay.
Good. Affordable. Now, less, in this case, is the opposite, right? Menos, right? Less expensive, but also it's a comparative, right? Good. And we use the word than after the adjective, when you compare two items, right? Vamos a la palabra than. Después de comparar dos cosas, for example, say, example, that suit is nicer than, es más, más bonito que el otro, ¿verdad? These gloves are more expensive than the other, son más caros que the other, right? The word than indicates que, in comparative, right? Good. Any question? This is the introduction, right? Now let's go to the specific rules for the comparative. The rules. Rule number one. Plus ER, right? ¿Cuándo vamos a agregar el sufijo ER? For example, when we have an adjective. Listen. Cuando tengamos un adjetivo que tiene una sola sílaba, right? Small. Recuérdense que las sílabas en inglés son por pronunciación, no por escritura. It's for pronunciation, no for spelling, right? Small. So we add, dice, pequeño, más pequeño, right? En español no nos complicamos, solo decimos más o menos, pero no. En inglés es más complicado. So it says small, smaller, right? Cheap, cheaper. Cheap has only one syllable, right? So, we say, más barato, cheaper, right? Como cuando le preguntamos a una señora de un canastillo ahí, ¿cómo tienen los mangos, verdad? Y todavía regateamos, hay algunos ingratos que regatean. So, cheaper, right? Lo quieren más barato. Okay, now, plus R, right? ¿Cuándo le vamos a agregar solo la R? En lugar de ER, the R, right? Cuando el adjetivo tenga una sola sílaba, large, for example, in this case, but ends in E. Pero en la escritura termina con E. So you say larger, es más grande. Grande, más grande todavía, right? Larger, right? Loose, flojo, right? Loose. flojo de holgado, no, no flojo de que no quiere trabajar, ¿verdad? De holgado, ¿ok? Loser. It's not loser, right? It's loser. Es un poquito más largo aquí el sonido. Loser. ¿Ok? Now, rule number one, rule number two. Questions?
Small.
Smaller. Cheaper. Large, larger. Lose, loser. Okay? Now, let's continue with the next rule. Rule number three, right? I-E-R. ¿Cuándo le vamos a agregar I-E-R? When the adjective has two syllables, cuando el adjetivo tenga dos sílabas, pero termine en Y, o sea, en Y, ¿verdad? Entonces, what are you going to do? You're going to change the Y to I. Vamos a cambiar la Y a la I. Y luego le agregamos ER, right? Heavy, pesado, right? Heavier, más pesado. Okay? Other example is pretty. We change the Y to I. And then you say, we have ER then. So we say pretty, prettier, right? Pretty, prettier. Okay? For example, we can say Morticia Adams is prettier, prettier than Tenchi Seliver, right? Okay? One example, right? Okay, rule number three, right? Rule number four. Consonant plus ER, right? Okay. Vamos a agregar una consonante y luego una ER cuando el adjetivo tenga una consonante, una vocal y una consonante. So this is the formula. Consonant, vowel, consonant. Yo siempre digo esto cuando las consonantes le hagan el sándwich a la vocal. Las consonantes haciendo un sándwich a una vocal. So, and we are going to double the last consonant. In this case, the G, right? So you say bigger, B-I-G-G-E-R, bigger, right?
G-E-R, big.
Hot. Consonant, vowel, consonant. Nuevamente, ¿verdad? Consonant, vowel, consonant. Las dos consonantes le están haciendo el sándwich a la vocal. Okay? So we double the last consonant. In this case, the T. So T-T. H-O-T-T-E-R. Hot, hotter. ¿Está caliente? Está más caliente, right? So, rule number three, rule number four. Any question? No? Okay, continue. Use more or less with adjectives that have two or more syllables and don't end with Y. ¿Qué va a pasar con los adjetivos que tengan más de una sola sílaba? Porque ya vimos que los que tengan solo una sola sílaba, pues le vamos a agregar ER, ¿verdad? Pero con los que tengan más o que, y que no terminen en Y después de consonante, bueno, entonces en ese caso vamos a agregar la palabra more cuando sea más y less cuando sea menos, right? So, more expensive, más caro, less comfortable, menos cómodo, right? Okay, that was rule number five. Regla número cinco, right? Rule number five. Any question? Make me question, please. Hágame preguntas porque después voy a hacer un quiz ahorita, de oral. Yes? Okidoki.
O sea, teacher, yes. O sea que vamos a utilizar more y less en todos los...
Adjetivos
que no están contemplados en las reglas anteriores. Correct. Digamos.
Correcto.
Ahí está. Bueno.
Correcto.
Thank you.
Okay. You're welcome. O sea, en pocas palabras, vamos a usar more en los adjetivos que tengan más de una sílaba, ¿sí? En general. ¿Sí? Expensive. Look, expensive. Tiene tres sílabas. Comfortable. Tres sílabas. Comfortable. Okay, good. Now, let's see some example, right? Pupusas are cheaper than pizza. Right? A menos que sea una pupusa loca, pero las normales son más baratas, right? Pupusas are cheaper than pizza. Okay. Pandas are nicer than monkeys. Al menos a mí me gustan más los pandas, ¿verdad? Okay, so rule number one, rule number two. Look. Elephants are heavier than dogs. Son más pesaditos los elefantes, ¿verdad? Que los chuchitos. So, heavier. Rule number three. Ah, sorry. I forgot, right? Hay una excepción. Con bad y good, vamos a usar, para good vamos a usar better, y para bad vamos a usar worse. Okay. Vamos a verlo. Give me a second. Vamos a compartirlo con usted. Okay. Por ahí tengo un micrófono encendido. Si nos hacen el favor de apagarlo, por favor. Ok, now. Good, right? Good. So the comparative form for good is irregular, so you're going to say better. Oh, better, right? For example, Alianza, right? Aunque perdimos ayer contra el Motagua, pero sigue siendo un buen equipo, ¿verdad? Alianza FC is better.
But.
No sé si voy a dañar algunas susceptibilidades por aquí, pero yo voy a poner este ejemplo. Dan FAS, right? Ya van como 6 finales que pierde el FAS contra la Alianza, así que tenemos propiedad para decir esto, ¿verdad? Alianza is better than FAS, right? Other example, right? Real Madrid is, oh, sorry, give me a second. Vamos a poner adjetivo antes. Is bad. The comparative form is irregular, right? Es irregular. Worse. Real Madrid is worse than Cádiz. Vamos a poner. Ok, perdón, Miguel, perdón. Es solo un ejemplo, Miguel.
True.
Ok. No quiero dañar susceptibilidades por ahí. Ok, okay. Real Madrid is worse than Cádiz, right? Ok. No, no sé por nada, pero tengo el presentimiento que Miguel es del Madrid, ¿verdad? Ok, now.
Solo porque es el único que le ha podido ganar, ticho.
Ah, ok. Sí, sí, pero verdad, en la Champions también ya le ganaron al Madrid. Bueno.
Teacher, yes, is worse that Cádiz or than Cádiz?
Real Madrid is worse that, oh, yes, I'm sorry, excuse me. Than, yes, thank you very much, thank you. No, Real Madrid is worse than Cádiz, right? Alianza is better than FAS. So, good and bad are irregular, right? Okay, perdonen por los ejemplos ahí, pero. Okay, now let's continue. Sigamos entonces. Okay, so Paris is better than Washington. That's my opinion, right? And a sofa is more comfortable than a chair. So comfortable has more than one syllable, right? Tiene más de una sílaba y no termina en Y. Good. Now, repeat after me, please. Repeat after me. Pupusas are cheaper than pizza. Pandas are nicer than monkeys. Elephants are heavier than dogs. Paris is better than Washington. A sofa is more comfortable than a chair. Good. Any question?
T-shirt.
Tell me.
Si fuera menos confortable, fuera a sofa is...
Less comfortable. Less okay. Comfortable than a chair, right?
Less.
Ahí depende okay. De su punto de vista. Si le parece una silla más cómoda, entonces el sofá es menos cómodo.
Solo, por el uso de, de ambas palabras.
Uh-huh. More is
más.
More es más, and less is menos, right?
All right. Okay. Thank you.
Yes, because in Spanish we say más o menos, but in English, más o menos is plus and less, right? Es un poco diferente en matemática, pero acá en los comparativos usamos more and less. Okay?
Okay.
Good. Now, let's practice, ladies and gentlemen. Let's start with Lorena. Hello, Lorena. What is the comparative for tall? Vamos a dejar opción para escribir, ¿verdad? Give me a second.
Hello.
Give me a second. Ahorita vamos a... Ok, Lorena. What is the comparative for tall?
Tall.
¿Qué regla aplicamos? La regla 1, 2, 3, 4, 5... Tall, ¿cómo decimos? Más alto.
Más alto.
No, vaya. Claudia Ordóñez le va a ayudar. ¿Claudia?
Sí.
¿Cuál es el comparativo of tall?
Taller.
Taller, right?
I-R.
I, no, E-R, right? E-R. Taller, right? Thank you very much.
Yeah. Now, sí.
Thank you. Now, Cindy, please. Exciting. What is the comparative for exciting, Cindy? Hello, Cindy.
Sería la I.
I. Ok, para comenzar, ¿cuántos sílabos hay aquí, Cindy? Exciting. Tres sílabos.
Sí, tres.
Ajá, entonces, ¿cuál vamos a usar?
More.
Le vamos a agregar una ER acá. Exciting her. O le agregamos una palabra.
More.
Sorry.
It's more.
More, correct. More exciting, right? More exciting. Thank you. More exciting. Okay, now, the next one, please. Who's next? Ana Maria, please. Interesting.
Interesting.
Mm-hmm.
Is more interesting or less more, interesting?
Very good. More or less, right? Oh, se me fue hasta acá la palabra. Sorry. Vamos a ver si lo arreglamos acá. Okay, more interesting, right? Easy. Juan Alfonso, easy.
Easy.
Mm-hmm. What is the comparative for easy?
R.
E-R. Like this? ¿Solo así? ¿O le falta algo más? ¿Falta algo más? Bueno, Alejandro nos va a ayudar entonces. Alejandro, please. ¿Le falta algo ahí a la palabra easier, Alejandro?
Ay.
Ay, right? Ay, ay, ay. So, remember, right? When the adjective ends in Y, we are going to change the Y to I, and then we add ER, right? So, easier, right? Conservative. Híjole, ya perdí el orden. Víctor seguiría. Víctor.
Yes, teacher.
Conservative, Víctor.
More conservative.
More conservative, right? Thank you very much. More conservative. Light. Iluminado, right? Light. Alonso.
Light.
Mm-hmm. More light, lighter, lightier, or what?
Lightier.
Light, lighter, right?
Lighter.
Okay, good. Yes. Thank you. Thank you. My, please. Liberal.
More liberal.
More liberal, correct. More liberal. Casual. Casual. Carolina, please. Casual.
More.
More casual, correct. Casual. It has two, right? Tiene dos sílabos y no termina en Y. Claudia Castro, please. Relaxing.
Less relaxing.
Less relaxing. Very good. Vamos a ver si lo ordenamos acá. Okay. Less relaxing. Thank you. Rolando, please. Heavy.
Why por la I?
Why por a, for I, right? Why por
I?
By I, and?
La I, R.
E, R. Heavier, right? Good.
Heavier.
And Alicia, la más difícil de Alicia. Constable.
More constable.
More comfortable, right? And Rosa, please, long. Rosa. Alcanza a ver la pantalla, ¿verdad, Rosa?
Se agrega ER.
ER, right? ER, longer. Very good. Unusual, unusual. Let me see who's next.
Unusual.
Alguien se me... Ah, Miguel. Miguel, please. Unusual, Miguel.
More unusual.
More unusual. Very good. Thank you al madridista del grupo. Okay, very good. No, es un gran equipo, ¿verdad? Por la Champions, el mejor de la historia, ¿verdad? Josué, please, short.
Short. Shorter.
Okie dokie. Scary. Vamos a ver qué me falta. Alonso, Víctor. Víctor, no sé si ya le pregunté. Víctor.
Hello, teacher.
Please, scary. Remember, scary movie, right? Woo.
Scarier.
Excellent. The Y? For I, right?
Y.
Mm-hmm. For I, yes. And then ER.
ER.
Correct. Very good. So that's it, right? Any question? Hoy sí podemos, ¿verdad? Now, I will close this. Okay. Now we go to the platform. Nos vamos a ir a la plataforma. Yes, we still have time. We're going to see the conversation first. And we're going to practice the conversation tomorrow, right? Only listen. To see the context of comparative in a conversation. The context
in this lesson, participants will listen to a conversation and will be introduced to comparison with adjectives by expressing preferences.
Which one do you prefer? Look, these jackets are really nice. Which one do you prefer?
I like the wool one better.
The wool one? Why?
It looks warmer.
Well, I like the leather one better. It's more stylish than the wool one.
Hmm, there's no price tag.
Excuse me, how much is this jacket?
It's $499. Would you like to try it on?
No. That's okay. But thanks anyway.
You're welcome.
Repeat after me, please. Look. No sé por qué me aparece este mensaje. Okay. Look. These jackets are really nice. Which one do you prefer? Notice this and one, right? Mm-hmm. Now, repeat, please. I like the wool one better. The wool one? Why? It looks warmer. Well, I like the leather one better. It's more stylish than the wool one. There's no price tag. Excuse me. How much is this jacket? It's $499. Would you like to try it on? $499. Would you like to try it on? No. That's okay. But thanks anyway. You're welcome. Now, let's see the video, right? And let's see the rules.
By the end of this lesson, you will be able to comprehend and use comparative adjectives.
Hi everyone, as I told you last class, we will talk about how to express preferences in English as well as to compare. Let's see.
Preferences. Comparisons with adjectives.
Which one do you prefer?
I prefer the leather one.
Which one do you like better?
I like the leather one better.
Which one do you like more?
I like the leather one more.
That one is cheaper than the wool one.
This one is nicer than the wool one.
The leather jacket is prettier than the wool one.
It looks bigger than the wool one.
It's more stylish than the wool one.
Spelling.
Cheap, cheaper, nice, nicer, pretty, prettier, big, bigger.
To express preferences in English, we may say, I prefer, I like. Which one do you prefer? I prefer the leather one. Which one do you like better? I like the leather one better. When we want to compare, we use the adjective in its comparative form. We use adjective plus er plus than. Small, smaller than. This dress is smaller than the other one. I recommend for you to study the adjectives in English in its comparative form, so you're able to compare anything you want. I also want you to work with this, cheap, old, and new. These are adjectives. Find out its comparative form and make comparative sentences using these three adjectives. Write them down in our discussion box.
Now, you have the information in the platform, right? We're going to check the knowledge check and we finish the class, right? Here we're talking about some vocabulary, right? Notice, please. We have, what are the things made of, right? Materials, cotton, no, algodón, right? Rubber, hule, gold, oro, el oro, right? No es el de color verde, es el del color dorado, el oro, es otro oro. Silk, no, seda, leather, cuero, silver, plata.
Plata.
Plastic.
Plástico.
And wool, that is... Lana, right? So, what are you going to do? It says, identify the material, right? And use the word from the list. For example, ring. What is correct to say? A wool ring? Un anillo de lana? Or a gold ring. I don't know. You take the decision, right? Take the decision. And you said jacket, socks, shirt, earrings, boots, etc., right? You choose the material. Look. En el dibujito está la respuesta. Okay. Good. And the last one, the demonstrative, right? Okay, then we have silk, polyester, small, medium, cotton, and wool, right? So what are you going to do here with this? It says, look at the pictures and complete using the comparative, right? Which dress is pretty or prettier? The green one is silk, and the silk is more expensive or expensivier? What is the correct form, right? Entonces vamos a ir viendo de acuerdo a lo que vimos, cuál es la forma correcta del comparativo, ¿ok? More big or bigger? Good or better, right? Etcétera, etcétera, ¿ok? Any question, class? It's time to go, right? Do you have any question? Okie dokie. Okay, so tomorrow we are going to have the meet. Yes, tell me. Sí, sí, dígame. Dígame.
¿Puedo volver a poner la presentación de saber vocabulario?
Vamos a hacer una cosa mucho mejor, Noemi. Se la voy a enviar al grupo.
Ah, ¿sí? Ok.
Sí, pero bye. Solo que termino mi clase, la otra clase a las 10. Entonces, por ahí, por esa hora, se lo voy a ir subiendo más o menos, ¿verdad? ¿Verdad? Para que vean todas las reglas y practiquen, ¿ok? So, thank you very much. Nos agarró la tarde, así que... Bye bye. God bless you.
Bye bye.
See you tomorrow.
See you tomorrow.
See you.